بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. البشاير انترناشونال سكول ان كايرو introduces this video for preparing IGCSE paper 1 exam in mathematics core curriculum. This video will be concerning only with geometry problems. Okay. Question number 1. The diagram shows the map of part of an orienteering course. Sanji runs from the start S to the point A. Can you take care from the start to the end? S is our start and A is our end. Okay, write S A vector as a colon vector. It's very easy. I will start with S and I want to move to A. Okay, move horizontally at first. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. So horizontally I have negative 3 here. And then vertically 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. So 4 here. Okay. A circle has a radius of 15 cm. Calculate the area of the circle in square centimeter. Of course, the rule of the area is pi r squared. And if we just substitute r with 50 cm, it will be pi times 50 squared, which is 7853.982. And in the instruction of this paper, of course, you know that we can write the answer only for three significant figures, so I can write the answer as 7850. Okay, write your answer for part A in squared meter. Okay, when we convert from meter to centimeter, we must multiply by 100, so that from centimeter to meter, we just divide by 100. But this is not meter, this is squared meter, so I must, to convert from square centimeter to squared meter, I must divide by 10,000 or 10^4. 10,000 means I will start with here and then move decimal points to 1, 2, 3, 4 places. It will be 0.785. Okay. The next question. Write down the mathematical name of a quadrilateral that has exactly two lines of symmetry. Okay. Of course, the answer will be rectangle. And also it can be rhombus. Write down the mathematical name of a triangle with exactly one line of symmetry. The equilateral triangle has three lines of symmetry, but the isosceles has only one line of symmetry. Okay, this is the answer. Write down the order of rotational symmetry of regular pentagon. Okay, for any regular shape, okay, for any regular polygon, the order of rotational symmetry will be the same as its number of sides, which is in the pentagon case 5. Okay. Okay, this is an interesting question. And the front of a house is in the shape of a hexagon with two right angles, as we see. The other four angles are all the same size. This angle and this angle and this angle and this angle are the same size. Calculate the size of one of these angles. Okay, the first step, I want to calculate all these angles together, sum of the interior angles of any polygon of n sides is equal to n minus 2. N is the number of sides. Okay, okay, I subtract n, I say n minus 2 all times 180 to get all the angles. This is the size of all angles or the sum of all interior angles. Okay, in our case we talk about hexagon, so we can put n equals 6, so that we have 6 minus 2, 4, 4 times 180, 720. Sum of all interior angles in this problem is 720. Okay, we can subtract 180, 90 plus 90 from 720. Okay, and then divide by 4 because we have 4 equal angles. So the answer will be 720 minus 180, all divided by 4, and the result will be 135 degrees. It's a very easy question now. In the diagram, AB is parallel to DE. AB is parallel to DE. Angle ABC is 110. This is 110. Okay, directly this angle would be 118 minus 110, which is 70, because this is a straight angle. The question is to find the angle BDE. This angle, okay? This angle. Of course, this is 70 and we have here the letter Z, which refers to the alternate angle. So the angle here is 70 also. Okay, in this interesting problem, TA is a tangent. TA is a tangent. Okay, once you read that this is a tangent, don't forget that this tangent is perpendicular to the radius directly. Okay, when you see a tangent, you should remember that this is perpendicular to the radius of the circle. Okay, angle OAB is 50. This angle is 50. Also, the triangle OAB is an isosceles triangle. Who can tell me why? Because OA is radius and also OB is radius. The first question is to find the measure of angle Y, okay? So it will be a get from noticing that OAB is an isosceles triangle. OA equals OB equals R, and then the measure of this angle is 15, and the measure of this angle also is 15. And if we say that 50 and 50 is 100, subtract them from 180 minus 100, so Y will be 80 only. Okay, the second item is for Z. I just told you that this tangent is perpendicular to this radius, so this angle is 90 minus 30 will be 40. The last one is the measure of angle T. Okay, the angle OAT is right at A. Okay, so the sum of measure Y and T is 90, of course, because 90 and 90 will be 180. Y is 80, so T is 20 only. Sorry, 10 degrees. Okay. Using ruler and compass, only construct a triangle with side 5 cm. Okay. It's a very easy question. I will tell you how to solve it only. The 5 cm side has been drawn for you. This is representing the 5 cm side. Okay, I will get the compass and open it at 6 cm and put it as here, as our center here. Okay. And open the compass at 6 cm and put an arc like this. Okay, and then I will put the center of the compass at the second end and open it for the third side, 7 cm, and make another arc. Okay, from this point of intersection, I will join this side and this side. Some of students don't use the compass here, and it's very wrong. Because in the mark scheme, it's written that for clear arcs only, the marks will be corrected. Okay, for clear arcs. So please don't forget to put these arcs and clear them. From the list write down, okay, the shape which has more than 6 lines of symmetry. Oh, more than six. Oh, we have a circle here, right? The circle has infinite lines of symmetry, so of course it has more than 6 lines of symmetry. Okay, certainly. Being a shape which has both acute and obtuse interior angles. Of course, you know the parallelogram. Okay, the parallelogram has 2 acute angles and 2 obtuse angles. Okay. Write each of the following as a single vector. Very easy. 3a, I just multiply 3 times 3 would be 9, and then 3 times 5 would be 15. Okay, second item, a vector minus b vector. I will say 3 minus minus 8, 3 minus negative 8, it will be 3 plus 8, 11. Okay, the second 5 minus 7, it will be negative 2. Three. A cuboid has a volume 288 cubic centimeter. The cuboid has 12 cm and width 5 cm. Calculate the height of the cuboid. Please start this problem with writing your rule. The volume of the cuboid equals length times width times height. Okay, just substitute. We want to get the height of the cuboid. the height. If we want to leave height as subject, we will say that height equals volume divided by length times width. Just substitute now, volume is at 288 divided by 12 times 5, resulting in 4.8 okay, centimeters. Let's be saying that 1 cubic centimeter of a cuboid has a mass of 4 gram. Okay? For only 1 cubic centimeter, it's corresponding to 4 gram. Work out the mass of the cuboid. Okay, its mass will be what? Its mass will be just multiplying. I will multiply the number of cubic centimeter with 4 gram. The volume, which is 288 times 4, we will get 1152. Okay, in this question, use a ruler and compass. Trace the region inside rectangle ABCD that is. This question for the locus, okay? And we have here two conditions. The first is more than 2 cm from AD. More than 2 cm from AD. Okay, we can use the compass to put its center at A and open it for 2 cm and make a small arc like here and another one here, or we can join it directly with the ruler. It's really easy, 2 cm from here, 2 cm from here, and join together. Okay, this say that more than 2 cm from AD. So our region here is less than 2 cm, but after this drawn line would be more than 2 cm. Another question, more than 4 cm from B. From B, the first condition talks about line segment, but the second condition talks about point. And so that we put our center of the compass here and draw an arc with 4 cm. Okay, the answer will be like this. Here's the line, which is 2 cm from the side, and I will put our compass here and make this R, but the answer will be like this. It is not a scale, that's for understanding only. Okay, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. Okay, for similarity, directly we can construct this proportion. I can say that AB over DE equals BC over D over EF equals AC over DF. And also you can get directly from the letters here, ABC and DF. If we take the first two letters divided by the first two letters here, and the second and the third, second and the third, and so on. Okay. After writing this proportion, we can just substitute. Will be 8 over 6 equal 10 over x equal y over 9, and then we can get x easily from these two ratios, and we can get y also from the first and the third one. The first required is x will be 6 times 10 over 8, which is 7.5, and the second item is for y will be 8 times 9 over 6, which is 12. Okay, work out this. The sum of the vectors will be 5 and negative 3, 2, and negative 1, 2 will be 1. B, A is the point 3 and 6, and B is the point 5 and 10. Work out AB vector. Okay. A is the start, B is the end. So, how can I displace A to B? I want A to move to B. 3 must go to 5 by adding 2 to it, so the first here is 2, and 6 to be 10, we must move 4 up, so the answer will be 4. Item C is the point 5 and 8, and CD vector is 1 and 2. C is the start. Okay, that asks the question for D, of course. To get D, I'll start from C, 5 and 1. It will be 6, and then 8 plus 2 will be 10. Okay. The shaded shape is made by joining a square and a rhombus. Okay, this is square and this is rhombus. This is the rhombus key. If we look at this shape with concentrating 5 cm here, we have some 5 cm here. Also, this is 5, this is 5, this is 5 because this is square. And also, the rhombus, from the properties of the rhombus, that all its sides are equal. So it's 5 cm here, 5 here, 5 here, 5 here. The first question is for the perimeter. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides, all of them with 5 cm. So the answer would be 30. 5 times 6, 30. The area of the shaded shape, to get the area, we must add the area of the square plus the area of the rhombus. Area of the square is just 5 times 5, and area of the rhombus will be length of the base times height. This is the height, which is 4.5. So I will make 5 times 5 plus 5 times 4.5, and the answer will be 47.5. Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB equal AC. Okay. This angle is 44. Of course, I can get the angle of ACB very easily by saying 118 minus 44 and divide the result by 2 to get the measure of this angle, which is 68. Being a regular polygon has an exterior angle of 40 degrees. Okay, we have a polygon, but this polygon is regular, okay? The major exterior angle of it is 40. Work out the number of sides of this polygon. Okay, we have a very important property for any regular polygon, that the sum of all exterior angles of any regular polygon is 360. So if we multiply the number of sides by the measure of one of the exterior angles, the result will be 360. And so that n can be picked by just dividing 360 divided by 40, which is 9 sides. The diagram shows an equilateral triangle. On the diagram, draw all the lines of symmetry. It's pretty easy. The first line will be like this, and the second like this, and the third like this. In this question, we don't say that use your ruler and compass. It will be just, you can use your ruler only, and directly you can write these lines of symmetry. Being in the space, we will draw a quadrilateral that has two lines of symmetry. Okay, we can draw a rectangle, and this item for writing its name, also a rectangle, okay? Work out, a circle has a radius of 6.4 cm, work out the circumference of the circle, the rule says that 2 pi r, just substitute the answer will be 40.2. The circle forms, this circle, the same circle, forms the top of a cylinder of 512. Centimeter. Work out the volume. The volume is pi r squared times h. Just substitute r with 6.4 and h with 12. The answer will be 1844.16, and we can rewrite it with three significant figures. Only 1540 is the answer. Okay, calculate the volume of this cuboid. It's pretty easy. Length times width times height. The answer will be 672 cubic centimeter. Item B. Another cuboid has width 6 cm, height 9 cm, and volume 625 cm. The required is to get the length. Okay, I will start with the same rule. V equal L times W times H, and the required. Sorry, the required is to get L will be volume divided by del times h, and the answer would be 12.5 cm. Okay. Okay, next. See, the diagram shows a right angle triangular prism. Okay, right angle triangular prism. Right. Calculate the volume of this prism. Okay, the rule said that volume equals area of the base times height. I will calculate the area of this right angle triangle and multiply it by the height, which is 24 cm. Of course, you know that the area of any right angle triangle is half times base times height. Okay, So the answer will be half 9 times 5, and the result is times 24, which is the height. The answer will be 514 cubic centimeters. Using a straight edge and compass, only construct the bisector angle ABC. Okay, I can say that for drawing a bisector, we center the compass at P here and draw an arc like this. This arc must cut the two sides of this angle, and then from the point of intersection, I will open the compass with suitable open, and then make an arc, and with the same open, I will put the center here with the point of intersection, and make another point, and just join B with the point of intersection of these clear arcs. I can give the bisector, which has very important property that all the points on this bisector are equidistant from these two lines. Okay. How to draw perpendicular bisector? Of course, you know that I will put the center of the compass here and open it more than half of the line segment and make an arc from up and from below, from both sides here, and put this the center of the compass here, and with the same open, I will make the other arc here and the other arc here, and join between points with the intersection of all the clear arcs. Okay, triangle ABC is isosceles and AC is parallel to BD. We have this isosceles. Okay, without completing the question, just for the isosceles triangle, of course, this is 40. We can say 180 minus 40, we have 140. We can divide it by 2, we have 70 here and 70 directly. Okay, the question is find the value of A and the value of B. Okay, it's very easy. A is 70, as we just said. And B, the measure of angle B is the same as the measure of angle C, because we have alternate angles here. It is it, okay? It's 40. Work out negative 2 minus negative 4. It's really easy. Minus with negative here, it will be plus. So negative 2 plus 4 is 2. And the second, negative 3 minus 7, it will be negative 10. B, 5 times vector 2 and negative 8, it will be 10 and negative 16. Negative 40. Okay. Write down the order of rotational symmetry of the shape. This is a very interesting question. If we draw only regular hexagon, the answer will be 6. But in this problem, we make 3 angles, which are black angles like this. Of course, the answer will be different now, because by this way, if we make 3 rotational symmetry only, we can't make 6. Okay, so the answer will be 3. And draw all the lines of symmetry on the shape. We have only 3 lines of symmetry. I want to tell you some important thing. If we make vertical line, this black triangle here haven't a reflection here. Huh? So the vertical line is not line of symmetry, just the horizontal one is the first, and the second must bisect this triangle also here, and the third must bisect this triangle here. So we have also 3 line of symmetry. Okay, work out the bearing of A from C. It's very important to know how to calculate the bearing of A from C. Okay, what letter after from C? We can stand here, okay, this is the north, and then move clockwise to reach the line AC. Okay, first this 28 degrees, and also this angle is 28, of course, alternate angles, and then stand here and move clockwise like this. How we can measure this angle? This is the bearing of A from C. Okay, it will be 360 minus 28, and the answer is 332. Calculate distance AB. Okay, it's really easy. It's the easiest theorem in geometry. We can say that AB squared equal 74 squared plus 26 squared, and AB only will be the square root, which is 78 Okay, this is square root of 26 squared plus 74 squared equals 78.43. For three significant figures, 78.4. Okay. Oh, it's a very important problem. Work out the value of x and then y. Okay. In the circle, we have this is a tangent. This tangent, and of course, this tangent must be perpendicular to the radius or the diameter. So all this angle is 90. X can be calculated by saying 90 minus 58, which is 32. Okay, what about Y? Here, E is on the circle. E is on the circle, and also the angle AEC is drawn in the semicircle. Or we can say that AC is diameter. This means that this angle must be 90 also. Okay, again, in the circle we have two important things. The tangent must be perpendicular to the radius, and any angle drawn in a semicircle, or in other words, any angle with the closed side is diameter, so this angle must be 90 degrees. So this is 90. It means that x and y is 90. So y would be 90 minus x, and of course it will be 58 again. Write down all you're working to show that angle ABC is right angle. ABC is right. Okay. This is the converse or the inverse of Pythagoras theorem, which states that if we squaring AC, the answer will be 1156. And also, if we squaring AB, it will be 256. If we squaring BC, the answer will be 900. Of course, if we add the two smaller sides length, it will the square of them, it will get the same as AC squared, which means that AC squared equals AB squared plus BC squared, and this means that this angle is right angle. Use trigonometry to calculate angle CAB. CAB, the required is this angle. Okay, what we know about this angle, we know all these side lengths. I can use 10 as an example. 10, this angle will be 30 over 16, and this means that 10 inverse 30 over 16 will be 661.928. for angles we can approximate for only one decimal point, so the answer will be 61.9. Thus the question now, the perimeter of the rectangle is the same length as the circumference of the circle. Okay, calculate the radius r of the circle. Okay, these two shapes have the same perimeter. Let us now calculate the perimeter of the rectangle. 6 plus 8 all times 2, it will be 28. And equating it with the circumference of the circle, which is 2 pi r, and easily can calculate r to be 28 over 2 pi, the answer will be 4.46. Okay, the diagram shows a quadrilateral drawn on 1 centimeter square grid. So the length here is represented by 1 centimeter. Write down the mathematical name of the quadrilateral, of course it's right, and then find the area of this quadrilateral and give the units. The rule said that half the product of two diagonals. Okay. This diagonal is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this diagonal is 1, 2, 3, 4. Just say half times 7 times 4, 7. It means 2 times 7, which is 14. And the unit is, of course, squared centimeter.